upside up like an egg. Stay away from me! All of you, you ghosty fucks. Monkey's got fucking golf clubs. Right in the dick. Right in the dick. Ow, right in the face. For backing right up into me. Right there. Okay. Thank you for the health. Take that, weird monster. Yeah, exactly, yes. Weird monkey dog. Monkeys and dogs. Ghosts make my head hurt. You wanna go? It's a heck of a shortcut. I'm back here, that's a hell of a shortcut. Wish that was open though. All the monsters I can kill are dead. In here, anyway. Let me move. I'm going to assume no. But I do need her. I wish you were unlocked. Bitch, would you come on? Why are you stalling? Honey. Ow, man. These fucking ghosts. Really, game? You had to, like, put 50 million of them? Stairs. Like, what the fuck? Thank you for finally fucking moving. Ah. Jesus. Game with the load screens, come on. Thank you. I would also like for her to follow me, not him. Okay! The fuck! Get the fuck off me! Teleport right in front of me, I didn't even know you were right there. It's all because she wants to delay herself on stairs, even though I'm running ahead of her. It doesn't matter. Games shouldn't fucking make an AI that are like, oh, you're too fast. I can't move now. Hello? Anyone there? Oh, no. He went into a door faster than I did. I'm behind now. Dead Rising 1 is the game that made me break a controller to begin with. So there's a lot of Dead Rising frustration coming out towards her AI because it's similar. Why I smoke. My PS2 controller can't take any more of abuse. It's so old that apparently it doesn't have a screw in the back of it anymore. I don't know what happened there. But my controller is so old. I have like 4 PS2s or had 4 PS2s. So I've had several over the course of the years, but I could literally see the inside of it. And yes, that was me accidentally causing inputs trying to open it. And I'm Brinkless and I covered wars, you know. Yeah, I love Dead Rising 1. That game is my bitch now, but that game used to kick my ass. I have YouTube videos of Dead Rising 1 and 2, and off the record, I need to play, and 3 as well. I also need to play 3 for my solo playthrough of that. Oh, hell yeah, he is. Dead Rising 1 and off the 1, 2 and off the record are undoubtedly some of the best ones. 3 is really good with friends, but I don't know how it is solo yet. And 4, I kind of just, without really much of a story and a lot of direction, it's just kill whatever the hell you want with whatever you want. And that bores me after a while. She walks. Yeah, she is very creepy.
Ow. Hey.
She also starts to freak out eventually. Like she's being controlled. And she'll hurt you. Like, there's ghost enemies in the game that hurt you just by being near you. That's why you see the screen freaking out there with those wheelchairs. Yes, the wheelchairs are ghosts. She eventually starts incanting shit. So someone takes over her mind sometimes throughout. And that was, it wasn't like that before. It started happening shortly after this portion of the game. Because she doesn't follow you throughout the whole game. She follows you throughout portion of it, and then some throughout that, she eventually starts getting possessed. So, because the main story of the game, the character, the villain of the game is going around killing a bunch of people. People thought he was dead. The main character's living in this apartment that the main villain was born in. Shit goes crazy for any tenants that live in there. So a lot of people I'm witnessing are dying with a bunch of weird numbers carved into them in a pattern of 1 to 21. She was a victim, but I guess survived? But my belief now is I think she's actually dead, because when she starts doing her possession thing, she starts hurting me like a ghost. So either she's possessed by some spirit, or she's actually a ghost, and Walter, the main villain's name, is actually able to control that. Be right back. Because no other victim that he's been through has survived. So I don't know how she would have lived. Oh.
food.
I have late breakfast and monkeys. Also, my room does creepy things, like I'll stare out the peephole through the door and there's a bunch of bloody handprints that appear the more he kills. Characters start acting weird. The girl that I'm with, actually, when you were able to see her in the apartment towards middle half of the game, she started acting weird, like talking to herself and shit. You'd hear noises. You could see people on the outside acting alright. But then you would see, like, the murder happen in Silent Hill, and then you would see the reaction in the real world. Shit like notes being given to me or other things will happen. This hole that I'm crawling through expands as you progress through the game. Now my room is actually haunting me and does hurt me. So a lot of things are starting to come out of the walls, and it's crazy. It's also where I save. It is crazy. Because it starts off normal first. You're able to come back here and heal and, you know, go over the lore and stuff like that. Now everything is hurting the fuck out of you. But you still have to return here. Because it's your hub. You can prevent it. There's items that you can use that can make sure it doesn't hurt you as bad. I've just used them. There's like holy candles like this one I can use to lessen the damage while I do things around the house. Like if I need to look out the window, there was a phone number I needed to call to find out another number for the line because it was canceled and they changed their number. I needed that for a code, so you had to call that number. Stuff like that, so you had to look outside to find that number on a billboard. Stuff like that. I've already did that. But yeah, there's things that you can use these for. I don't need it as of right now that I know of. But sometimes this door, you can look out it. You can see bloody handprints on the wall outside. Sometimes there's notes that you'll be given throughout certain events. So as you proc certain parts of the game, you'll come back here with certain... I probably, once I finish this world, I'll probably have a note for me. I also don't know what I'm all missing. I could also be missing a lot of secret stuff as I come through that hole or not. I don't know. Because I don't know what procs I've missed. I don't know what secret stuff I didn't look at. I don't know what... Either way, it's a first playthrough. It's not really a big deal. dead.
Don't go too far ahead.
And I need her to go through these doors. This area is finished. Fucking hell! They're just walking on a boss fight? A bunch of balls? Too close to that one. Oh, great. Lovely. And here's a lot. What am I missing? Oh. There's the message. Reach the deepest part, you must defeat the one true. Do so, and this door will open. Okay. Thank you. Oh. Okay. Thanks! That was easy, actually. Alright. Yes, my health. Who just got bitch smacked a few times by a bunch of walls? Let's see if there's anything I can do with it. Yeah, so there's a note right there. scrap of paper. Number one, 10 heart. Number two, 10. Number three, 10 hearts. Number four, 10 hearts, Steve Garl. Number five, 10. Number six, 10 hearts. Seven, 10 hearts, Billy Locane. Number eight, 10 hearts, Miriam Locane. Number nine, 10 hearts. Number 10, 10. Number 11, Sumption, Walter Sullivan. Number 12, Void. Number 13, Darkness. Number 14, Gloom. Number 15, Despair, Joseph Schreiber. 16, Temptation, Cynthia Velasquez. 17, Sir Jasper Geen. Watchfulness. Number 18, Andrew DeSalvo. 19, Chaos, Richard Braintree. Number 20, Mother, Eileen Gallivan. That's the girl that's following me. Number 21, Wisdom, Henry Townsend. That's me. Mother. Wisdom. Okay, those are the plaques now. Chaos, Watchfulness, all those. And Andrew was the ghost guy that I killed or stopped to get the key from. Ooh. No wonder Eileen's, I knew that her rabbit plushie was gonna turn and point at me. I knew that Henry was the next victim. Obvious. That's why he's after me. That's why Walter's after me. I'd presume a lot of those missing ones were the ones that where they were killed, but their heart wasn't ripped out. My shoes have moved again. Some spoop. Hopefully I don't die. I should have enough health to hopefully get me through. Weird dancing doll. Are you okay?
Hartman World.
There's a diary on the ground. I had the weird dream today. The one with the man with the long hair and the coat. He was crying and looking for his mother again. I saw the man with the coat 10 years ago at this apartment. He was going up the stairs carrying a heavy tool and an old-looking bowl and a bag that was dripping blood. I never saw him again after that, but a few days later, the neighbors complained that they heard strange noises coming from the supposedly empty room 302. So I took a look around 302 and found signs that someone had been in there, but nothing odd other than that. But that's when all started. I still hear strange noises come from the window of room 302. Sunderland. Put the superintendent's diary in the coat and do your script. Right. Superintendent lived in here prior to me. Apartment World. Hey, look, it's my apartment. An old picture book and a red book here. There was once was a baby and a mother who was connected by a magical cord. But one day the cord was cut and the mother went to sleep. The baby was left all alone, but the baby made lots of friends at the wish house, and everyone was very nice to him. There the baby was happy.
His friends told him how to wake up his mother, so the baby went right away to go wake her up. But the mother would not wake up. No matter how hard he tried, she wouldn't wake up. Because the one that he was trying to wake up was actually the devil. The baby had been deceived. Poor baby. The baby cried and cried and cried. When he thought of the mother, he remembered the feeling of being connected to her through the magical cord. Just then, the ray of light came down from the sky. The light was very warm and made the baby feel good. When the baby looked into his hand, he saw the magical cord was lying there. With the cord clutched in his hand, the baby went happily to sleep. Neat story. Crimson Tome. She who is called the Holy Mother, be not holy one whit. The descent of the Holy Mother is not but the descent of the devil. Those that be called the 21st sacraments, be not sacramental one whit. The 21st sacraments be not but the 21st heresies. To give birth to a realm of wickedness within the blessed realm of our Lord, be blasphemy in the work of the devil. If thou would stop the descent of the devil, you must bury part of the conjurer's mother's flesh within the conjurer's true body. Thou must also pierce the conjurer's flesh with the 8 spears of void, darkness, gloom, despair, temptation, source, watchfulness, and chaos. Do so and the conjurer's unholy flesh will become that which was once it was by the grace of our Lord. Oh, good Lord. A lot. I feel like I'm playing Phasmophobia. Hello? How old are you? Are you here? What's your name? Amen, yeah. The door's shut tight. The hallway! Okay, so this is the hallway, I was gonna say. This is how I came in. Alright. I gotta reorient myself. I was gonna say, I would love to explore the actual hallway, but no. Should've guessed. Can it load faster, please? God. Alright. Alright. My hallway. Bathroom. Big giant hole, my bob. The gate? Hell. Thank you. Oh. It's a piece of red paper. It's covered in blood and rust. This is my room. But what the hell has happened to it? This room. Is it really my room? It's in terrible shape. The air is so heavy. My head hurts. Creepy. It looks like a face. What the hell am I writing? August 2nd. Joseph. Oh. Old typewriter. Can't break down the wall. August 3rd, just. When the bell rings, Eileen equals mother's body. Well, blood. August 4th, Joseph. She's right next to me, though. Jesus, how many notes do you have? Crimson Tome. Bury part of the conjurer's mother's flesh within the true body of the conjurer. Part of flesh equals super's room? The notes. Indeed. The gate to hell. What does this one say? I must destroy this wall. Sure. Ow, I'm in my room again. Wait. Oh. So, okay, that acts as a portal back home. That makes sense. I didn't know if that was going to be a portal within a portal within a portal portal portal. Funny enough, that's actually where the original portal was. Which is right here. It was sealed. Ow, 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 ow. See, the original hole is sealed. There's probably things in there, though. Woo! And it's dark fast. 10 minutes ago, I was walking the dog. It's still pretty light. Now it's almost damn. It's hot. Still love that I missed the revolver. Bloody footprints. Hello. Hi. Imagine having someone crawling into your house like that. I'd be fucking terrified. Oops, made an extra save. Return from room 302 of the past. So here's what the hallway looks like. It's... As the game progresses, early on, you see people outside, but as the game progresses, it gets darker and darker, and that disappears. But as each kill happens, Walters puts a new handprint on the wall. And then there's also, right near where Creepy Boy is, there's a spot on the wall that actually you can peep through into Eileen's room, the girl that's actually following me. You can actually peep into her room. Hey, it cleared up in here. So this is the new portal that I had to make with these placards. Centuries ago, it's easy to remember. Man didn't know so well. I was gonna say, I think you got the wrong house. Yeah, definitely did. Oh, oops, wrong house. I don't think I'm haunted today. Yeah, definitely. Huh? I knew it. She's possessed. And we just walked right into it, I think.
It's him.
You've done well to make it this far.
Maybe not, but still.
Let me tell you something about him. Walter Solomon. When he was a little boy, he began to believe that my apartment was actually his birth mother. He decided to free her from the stains and corruption of this world.
It's the booby man.
He learned of the 21 sacraments, the only way to purify her. He then performed the ceremony of the Holy Assumption and created this twisted world. Now, he's become nothing more than an inhuman killing machine. Well, he's dead now, but he's still trying to complete the 21 sacraments. His boyhood desire to return to the bosom of his birth has divided him. Now his child self has manifested itself in this world, and soon he's planning to finish his work, the 21 sacraments.
Don't run yourself out of money.
Number 20, the mother reborn, Eileen Galvin. Number 21, the receiver of wisdom, Henry Townsend. Even now, it may not be too late. Follow the crimson tome. Stop. If not, wherever you run, he will catch you. Find him. His true location. It must be nearby. You must kill him. You must kill him. Kill. Kill.
The real room would be here.
Kill.
He was born here. That's right.
The mother was born. The crimson tome. Obey the crimson tome.
I need to kill. Her flesh needs
kill
to be returned.
Must kill him.
Not the one.
Kill.
But HM said
kill.
Yeah.
Kill.
Kill, 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 kill. Kill. There's a pickaxe stuck in the wall. Take the pickaxe of hope. Part of the conjuring mother slash another conjurer's true body. Here's the conjurer's flesh. Void, darkness, gloom, despair. Conjurer's mother flesh within the true body of the conjurer, part of the flesh. Part of the flesh is in the super's room. When the bell rings, Eileen's mother's body. Thank you.
move. Like, I'm trying to not hump you.
He used this place as the locus for the creation of his world. I'm certain he must have performed the ritual of the Holy Assumption near here, but I'm just not trying to stop me. He locked me up in this room and played with me just like a toy. Giggity. My eyes are starting to go blind with pain. I can feel my body starting to die. But things are taken care of. Whoever lives here after me, you'll be the 21st. The last of the sacrifices. I leave it up to you. When the bell tolls, the ritual begins. Eileen equals mother's body. Blood, part of the mother's flesh, equals a superintendent's room. This is all that I've been able to figure out. I hope this letter gets to you in time. So I need Eileen's body and blood to be sacrificed in the super's room. This is as far as I'm going. This is it. This is the world I'm in. There's really no exploration around. So it's either between here and mine. Yeah.
doodle doodle doodle. Obsidian. What the hell is Walter doing in here? His body is tangled on some kind of pipe. There's something in his coat. Keys of liberation. Extremely evil looking keys. Help. This has been here from way before I moved in. Bags of blood and things like that. If liberation. Alrighty. Do I still have to use this all in the physical realm? So, yeah, actually, hold on. Let me try the... Yeah, I didn't think so. But it looks like, yes. Yes, I do. Probably. It's keys of liberation. It probably opens the locks. Well, that explains how Walter got them locked from the inside. It's kind of gross. Also explains why the house and everything is haunted constantly. Not just because of Walter's bullshit and cult shenanigans, but he's actively did it all from here. You really think you would escape? You need to finish the nightmare first.
Eileen?
I don't think that's good. She's actually not harming me. Okay, good. I thought she was gonna be bad. This point.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Walter.
Ooh, I'm a ghost now.
Son of a bitch, move! Fuck you! Painted department. Okay, no, I want that, yes, because there might be ghosts.
Yeah.
Yes, I will take that. Oh, hi. Hi there. Ow! Don't stand in the opening. Son of a bitch, she's in here. Fucker, I can't.
wants to be a douche about putting a cap in me, fine. Outside room 302. I'll be right back. I'm tired of losing that progress.
I'm healed up and he's fighting.
Yeah, I'm still missed shit there. Pickaxe of despair. Silent shit.
Thank you.
Ole. Eileen's blood.
Yes.
Oh, this is Eileen's room.
I don't have a revolver.
I missed it. Thank you.
This is the gun Richard was using. There's his revolver. Resolve. Well, the Maximus is easy to use. There's my revolver. Okay, so I didn't miss it. Lovely day. Save point is gonna be mine. Thank you.
Do that. Keep going the wrong way. Stairs are behind me, literally to the side. Green Hornets live, Pretty Mean Girls live. Send love to Green Hornet. He's doing some Dying Light.
Send love to Pretty Mean Girl who's playing Dead by Daylight.
Yo, what the fuck is going on?
Oh my god, he's won. How did I lose that?
I don't know. Oh, fucking hell.
Port me out. Just leave.
There ain't no way.
Thank you.
Send love to Proman74, who's currently going with some Apex right now. And send love to Melee Lin, who's going live with Genshin Impact.
You left early to do your pills.
Yeah, I can talk.
Oh shit, I'm way... Why I'm so low?
Because you... Bro, you left yesterday. You left early yesterday to do your bills. So...
Blows to meet around me. Kill it! Fire! Mice aren't too bad. If you don't like mice, I apologize. So cute, always one of them. Yeah, they can be adorable. Still didn't see that thing though, but I hear it every day. Oh, that big thing running around the house. Well, I'd rather not have anything running around the house. That sounds disturbing. I don't even know, it's just in general, if it's a wild rodent, in general, you don't know what they're carrying, also. I mean, for all you know, it can infect you, and then you infect everyone else, and then you begin the Resident Evil apocalypse. Competition between the ceilings. Ah, he thinks it's Fast and Furious up there. Something with him, I think. Was that thing? Oh, that's scary and creepy.
Oh.
am pulling a healing thingy. So if they're prepping me. I'll take it. So that's the only way in and out, alright. My mom doesn't want to use poison. You can buy an electron. Wow. Understandable, I guess. Six chains in the way, I can't open the door. Superintendent's room, I guess. I don't recall which number his was, but yeah. Either way. Yes. Walter's father. Neat. There are lieutenant's lockers, yes. I knew it. I can't get out this way. I know what they are.